Good afternoon, guys. It is Monday and I'm about to sit down with a little cup of tea. I'm gonna pop my light on. How cute is my light? So I'm gonna sit down with a cup of tea and I'm gonna pick out a little treat. I think I'm gonna have a whisper. But yeah, today I was in uni this morning. We were at like this exam prep thing. Okay, I can't do this with one hand, so I'm just gonna take the whole pack. But yeah, we were doing that and then we had a seminar which was, to be honest, not even worthwhile going to, so that was a bit annoying. But I am back now. I went to Home Bargains and did a little bit of shopping, so that killed some time, and it's now 2:30. So I'm gonna sit on my bed and I'm gonna drink my cup of tea before it gets cold, and I'm gonna eat my chocolate, and then I'm gonna get on. I need to get some revision done, I need to get some dissertation work done, and I need to do some ironing, so it's gonna be a busy day. Of course, while I drink my tea, I'm going to be watching How to Get Away with Murder. I think I'll just let myself watch another episode and then I shall get one. Good evening, guys. I forgot to open up my advent calendar, so I thought let's open that just now. I'm going to have to pull it down with both hands. It's really heavy. Give me one sec. Okay, so I've spotted 5. It is here. So let's have a little look and see what is inside. I'm rather excited. Do I think it's wrapped in paper? Oh. Feels like a squeezy top, like some sort of bottle of oil or something. Let's have a little look. What's in here? This is really awkward for camera. Ooh, yeah, it's some sort of oil. Now, let's see, it's, what's it called? Oh, it's Josh Wood's hair treatment. Nice, that's pretty cool actually, because I have just finished up the oil that I'm using at the moment, which is Percy and Reed. So that's very handy. I wonder when you put it on though. It says add it as a pre-shampoo treatment or a few drops to smooth and add gloss to your finished look and to condition the hair. So that looks really nice actually, and I've never tried anything by Josh Wood, so that'll be pretty interesting. Guys, I've been attempting to do uni work but it hasn't really been happening, which is basically the story of my life, because I just feel like I have no idea what I'm doing and this dissertation is just a complete and utter guessing game, so it's not great. But honestly, I just need to sit down at a desk and I just need to do it. I made some notes about various different things and I did look over my aims and objectives for my dissertation to try and sort of refine them, so I have made a little bit of progress, but definitely a little bit and not enough for what I should have done today. So tomorrow's a new day. I need to stop procrastinating and I need to get on. Good morning, guys. It is Tuesday today and it's advent calendar opening time. I think it's the 6th of December. I'm pretty sure I opened 5 yesterday. Yeah, definitely opened that one. So number 6, let's have a little look and see what is inside. It's so funny because my friend Rachel messaged me last night and she is a girl that I met in the Netherlands on exchange, and she was like, I'm so invested in your beauty calendar. So yeah, this is for you, Rachel. Guys, this is literally like the best thing ever, right? Because the eyeliner that I use at the moment is, I'm sure it's the Ico. I'm sure it is. It's an Ico Fat one. Here it is here. Yeah, the Ico Fat Mascara, and it's literally, mascara? Eyeliner, and it's literally my favourite eyeliner ever. I'll show you the tip on this one that I'm using at the moment. So that's it there, and then the one that I got in the advent calendar is the skinny one, which is perfect because obviously I have the fat one, so this is ideal, it's not going to focus. So I'm really excited to try the thin one as well because I love this eyeliner. I feel like it stays on all day and it's perfect. So yeah, like literally I just feel like this calendar just gets better and better. So yeah, it's currently Tuesday morning, it is 10:15 and I have spent the morning replying to YouTube comments. I'm basically sitting on my phone, so it's been very unproductive so far, although I did move some of the cars out the driveway about an hour ago because my mum's heading off to work, and normally they would just have been my car, but my brother's car is there because he's actually in his bed sick, so a little bit worried about him, but I'm sure he'll be fine. He's probably just needing to sleep it off. I think he's got a sore throat. So yeah, today I am going to just sit and get on with a little bit of work, but first of all I'm going to cleanse my face because I was really naughty last night and I went to bed without cleansing my face. So I'll bring you guys into the bathroom and I'll have a little chat with you while I use my Emma Hardy cleansing balm. I've had some breakfast. I had this because my mum had got this cheap in M&S, the wheat-free cheese sandwich, and then I had half of it yesterday before my dinner, and then I thought, you know what, I'm just going to have the other half for my breakfast. But it's not great in terms of the content, so that's why I like to split it over 2 days. I didn't want it to go to waste, but literally it's all red. And it's so funny because Craig and I were having this discussion the other night, like, about how we have, like, the fear of that. Like, I don't know if any of you guys do as well. Like, maybe in your countries you don't have that, but in the UK it's, like, mandatory to put on the front of your products this sort of traffic light system. So it's really interesting. But what I also find interesting is the fact that you don't find that on sweets, so there must be some sort of regulations that allow that they don't have to put that, because it would put you off. I mean, that literally puts me off. Like, I care about what's going in my body, and when I look at that, it just gives me the absolute fear that this one sandwich is 39% of my daily salt intake. Like, it's just crazy. So I think that's the logic behind not putting it on, like, chocolate and sugary sweets and stuff, because people just wouldn't buy it. They'd get a fright, they'd look at the reds across the board, and they just wouldn't pick it up. I mean, I probably wouldn't pick up as much chocolate as I do, if I was able to see that and see exactly what was in it and not have to go to the back and actually read it for myself, because I tend to just ignore that. But anyway, I'm going to make myself another cup of tea because I didn't get through this one, and I think I'm going to pop a wee sugar in it just to make it a little bit more enjoyable. And I'm also going to have a banana to try and be a little bit healthy. And then I don't know what I'm going to have for lunch, but I'm going to have to get in the shower around 12:30 because I need to leave at 1:30. I'm going into uni for a class. We've just got one lecture today, but it's like a revision class, so I do want to go in for that. I need to mention Amy being mum, because I've mentioned her before, but she's just absolutely fab and I love watching her videos, and she's doing a Vlogmas, so you guys should go and check her out. This is her here, and I'll leave a little link to her channel down below, because she is Scottish as well, so you know us Scots got to stick together. But no, she's a lovely, lovely girl, and she's got absolutely gorgeous kids. She's got two. She's got Caitlin, who's a little bit older, and she's got Elle, who is her baby. So yeah, I think that's really all I've got to say sitting here. But I know what my topic of discussion is going to be in the bathroom. Okay, I've popped you in the cupboard. I think this is going to work. I'm a little bit small, but if I stand on my tiptoes, then we're good. But yeah, I wanted to talk to you about Vlogmas. So, first of all, I'm going to get my cleanser. I've talked about this over and over, but it is the Emma Hardy Cleansing Balm. Well, it's that amazing face Moringa Cleansing Balm, and I absolutely love it. The last time I bought it in these little little travel ones, because I felt that having the big one was meaning that it was getting, like, watery, and it just wasn't very nice. Like, I didn't feel like the cleanser was staying fresh. So I bought the travel ones because it actually worked out. You got more for your money, I'm pretty certain. And also it means I can take them away with me if I ever go anywhere. But yeah, I'm just going to pop this all over my face. So what I was saying was that I wanted to talk about Vlogmas. I have always wanted to do Vlogmas, and it's something I've never been able to achieve since I've been on YouTube, because I've had commitments. Since the start of YouTube, I have been in university. When I first started out, I was doing a different course, but now obviously I'm doing the course that I'm on. I'm in fourth year, so I just don't have the time and the ability due to my commitments at the moment. But it is something I would love to do in the future. Sorry, I'm standing on my tiptoes, this is really sore. Something I'd love to do in the future, and definitely next year I'm going to consider. Obviously I have no idea where I'm going to be next year. I could be in a full-time demanding job, but, well, I'm hoping to be in one like that. But we'll see. We'll see what's happening, but I'd love to do it next year. But yeah, I wanted to sort of talk about it, because do you guys just feel, like, overwhelmed? Like, I literally just feel like I don't know who to watch, because everybody's doing Vlogmas, and that's the other thing. It's quite a sort of saturated thing now, isn't it? And so many people do it that it's difficult. Like, I don't even know. Why is this making me sound funny? It's like the scent of it's making my voice go weird. I don't even know if it would be particularly watched, because there's just so many other people that do it that are better than me. But yeah, it's something I'd love to do, because I love getting in the whole festive spirit, and I just love filming this time of year. But maybe I'll consider it another month as well, maybe next summer, once I don't have uni anymore. I could do, like, Vlogmas or something like that. Anyway, I'm gonna go and wipe this off. This is my awful attempt at drawing this. It's not really working, is it? Okay guys, so I'm ready to head off to uni. I'm just going through for that hour. But I wanted to show you my outfit because I feel like it's a little bit brighter than usual. I feel like I wear quite dark clothes, like black and grey, and yeah, sometimes it's nice just to lighten it up. So I've done that today. So I'm wearing this coat that I got a while ago from Oasis, although it is a little bit tight. But I can still do it up, it does still fit me. But I definitely need to lose a little bit of weight to be able to fit back into it. But I'm wearing it, and I'm also wearing a little top underneath, which is just from Primark, just a little roll neck top. And then I've got on my jeans and my Converse, which Craig got me. So yeah, that's pretty much the outfit. And I'm just going to wear this little light bag as well, which is from Oasis, which you guys have seen before, I believe. I can't get off my seat, damn it. There we go. This little bag. So yeah, it's a lot lighter. It's a lighter outfit. But I was just feeling something a little bit brighter and not my average black and grey. And I've obviously switched up my glasses as well because these ones go a little bit better with this outfit. But anyway, I'm going to go, I'm going to head off to uni, and I might see you tonight. Good morning, guys. It is Thursday, and I'm really not looking my best right now because I've basically just come back from Craig, so I haven't showered, I haven't done my hair, I have no makeup on, and even my glasses are dirty, so this is a complete and utter fail. Anyway, I'm about to just put a wash on, and I'm heading to work at 1, I believe. I'm going to double check because they do tend to change my shift, so they might have changed it to 2, but I'm going to check that. But I went to put a wash on, and I just grabbed like a pair of bottoms that were on my bed. When Craig was last here, he was wearing like joggies, and bearing in mind, they're massive for him, and then I decided it would be a good idea to put them on, so they're absolutely massive. You can probably see them, they look like, I don't know, big grandpa pants or something. But I'm totally rocking them, it's fine. So my room is a total riot. I've got this pile of washing to go in, I've got this pile of washing that's clean to deal with, I need to put this somewhere, and it's just a big riot right now, but that's fine. I'm going to put my wash on, tidy up my clean washing, and then I'm going to get into bed. I'm going to watch some videos, or maybe some How to Get Away with Murder, and then I'll get in the shower eventually. Oh, it's time to do advent calendar, so I think I've missed 2 days, the 7th and the 8th I believe, so let's have a little look. I think I've done 6, let's double check. Pretty sure I did it with you guys. Yay, that was the eyeliner, perfect. So let's move on to 7 and see what we've got here. What is this? Oh, it's sun cream. That's really handy actually for the face, and it's the brand Ultra Sun, and it's 30 SPF 30. That's really handy actually. I'll put that away for the summer, because I don't know, like your face is always like an area you sort of forget about, so dead handy to have. And then numero 8, where is it? Am I blind? I can't. Ah, here it is. Oh, what's in here? It's Alpha H Liquid Gold. Now, I feel like I've heard about this. I don't know why I would have heard about this, but it's something for your skin. So, I don't know, I need to read up on this, because, like, I don't know. The sort of title sort of, like, scares me, but I don't know if it's going to be any good. It's talking about applying it with a cotton pad each alternative evening. I need to read up on this, but I definitely have heard about this. Good afternoon, guys. It's Friday and it is currently 20 to 2, and I have been very unproductive this morning. As per usual, I was aiming to get up and just get on and do some work, but it's just not happened, and I spent the full morning trying to find Christmas presents for my parents, and that just wasn't happening either, and it's just been like just a nightmare of a day. And then I made lunch, and what I made in the oven was just awful and I had to bin it, so then I just had rice, and it's just a disaster day. But I'm determined to turn it around. I'm not going to be a negative person anymore. Today is going to go well. I'm going to go to the shop, I'm going to get some decent food so I can have a good dinner, and I'm going to post some cards that my mum wants me to post, and what else was I going to do? I'm going to go to Boots because I need to get a few essentials as well. So I'm going to bring you guys along with me because I haven't done any vlogging today, and I didn't vlog yesterday, so you can come along for the ride, and I'm going to share with you what I'm going to buy. I think I'm going to go to Aldi and just have a look. Like, I have no idea what you even want. I need to get something for dinner tonight, but I don't know what I'm going to eat. So I'm just hoping that something's going to inspire me when I'm in the actual shop, because I want it to be healthy. I want to be getting like nutrients in my body and eating well. So that's the aim, and then come back with the food, and I'm going to get on with the work. I'm not going to think about the future and everything and how much of a dissertation I have to do because I have the whole thing, but I'm going to just sit and I'm going to read lots and lots of stuff and take notes and just go through so much literature to try and just get my head around it all and make a start with that. I don't necessarily want to write anything today, I just want to read, take notes, find references, and just sort of get my head around it because I just feel so stuck. I feel stuck with a lot of things right now, and because I'm stuck, I'm procrastinating because I don't want to do them because I'm scared, I don't know what to do. Like, and I just feel so on my own with this dissertation. I mean, probably you guys can relate. Like, if you've got any advice, like, that would be greatly appreciated because I just feel really, really stuck. Like, I'm struggling and, like, I just want to change the whole thing. I don't even feel like what I'm doing is good enough, and I'm worrying that I'm not going to have enough to write about, and it's a nightmare. I hate it. I want to be done with uni. I want to be working a job where I can go to my job, do my job, come home and actually chill, because at the moment it's like I'm in a constant state of like nervousness and anxiousness about all the things I have to do and all the stuff that's never getting done, so it's not good. But as I said, I'm going to turn it around. I'm going to head off, get some food and do a few different things and then come back and get on with it. Why are we so hard on ourselves in life? Like, I just feel like I'm being so hard on myself today. From that footage, I look at myself and I just feel like I look overweight. I can't see any positives. And I don't want to be that guy. I want to be a positive person. Like, I don't know. Today is just not a good day, but that's another thing that I've been struggling with recently is just my weight and how I'm looking, and I'm not happy at all, and I just feel like I have so much going on and I don't know how to handle any of it. I can't cook, so I can't cook myself anything nice, and on top of that I don't have enough money to buy anything nice, to cook anything nice, and my weight is spiraling out of control. I need to lose at least a stone. I'm not happy looking at myself in the mirror. I don't feel confident, and uni's just there, just constantly there, just a stress, a pressure, and just a little bit fed up today, can you tell? I don't know, I just wish I had just manageable situations, but right now my life just doesn't feel manageable, it feels out of control and not very nice, quite frankly, but yeah, moaning about it isn't going to do anything about it, so I should go and get on. How nice is this tree in our hallway, by the way? I have no idea where my mum got this. I think someone gave it to her, but it's so pretty. I noticed it was in the background of that footage, and I just think it looks absolutely awesome. But yeah, my apologies for the moans. This has definitely been a long enough section of this vlog. Right, so I thought I would share with you what I got at Aldi. So I got this bag of mixed vegetables, which I thought was just really handy to pop along with something. For example, tonight's tea, which is going to be this, which is some chili, lime and coriander chicken breasts. They look really nice. So I'm going to have one of them tonight and probably the other one tomorrow. And I'll have some vegetables and I'll have some potatoes. I got a bag, that one looks a bit brown actually. I got a bag of Scottish Baby Maris pure potatoes, whatever that means. But Maris Piper potatoes are really nice. And then I got some white seedless grapes, which I can have with my Greek yogurt, which I bought. And then I got 3 bags of the whole grain and quinoa rice, because I really like that to have with like fish cakes or something like that. And then the last thing I got were a little bag of these buttery minis. Yeah, so that's everything I bought. And all of this came to, where's my receipt? I think it was about a tenner. Yeah, £9.97. So that's not too bad for all of that, because essentially it's going to do me 2 dinners, and then they're like half of a dinner. And then I got a snack and I also got some treats. So I'm going to make a cup of tea, I'm going to get my laptop and set it all up here with all my different things, and I'm going to get started on some work. I'm not going to procrastinate it anymore. I'm going to have a cup of tea and a little bubbly mini to cheer myself up, and I'm going to get started. Alright guys, so it's been a few days since I have opened this. It's currently Monday and I'm going to share a few different days with you. We're on the 12th today and I think the last one that I showed you was the 8th, so I've got the 9th, 10th, and then I don't know where 11 and 12 are. There's 12 and I don't know, there's 11. Okay, perfect. So I'm going to start with 9 and let's have a look and see what's inside. Oh, this one's right at the bottom. I'm so intrigued. Like, I'm excited because I have about, like, well, I have four to open. No, I have five. 9, 10, 11, 12. No, four. Just can't do the maths. Oh, it's a nail varnish. What is it? It's an autograph. Yeah, that's actually gorgeous. And I love getting, like, nail varnishes that I don't have anything like. And that one, I do not have anything like that. It's, like, reddy but pinky at the same time with, like, a hint of orange shimmer. It's absolutely stunning. So it's autograph and it's called Cranberry. Perfect. So I'm actually going to paint my nails with that today because, as you can see, I don't have anything on them. Okay, so moving on to 10. Let's have a little nosy. Oh, it's in a packet as well. Ah, they're hard to get out. And I hate when they're in this because it just makes it really awkward. Right, two spots. Oh, no, it's coming. Yay! what's this one? Oh, it's another nail varnish. Wow, it's a nails ink gel. That's an absolutely gorgeous colour as well. That's like a darker red. And I absolutely love any sort of red, so that is perfect. Now, I don't know which one to use today. What one do you think? I do like this, though. It's really different, but they're both absolutely gorgeous. Okay, so number 11, which is here. This is a big one. I don't even know how to open it. Okay, we're in, and it's wrapped up again. See if I can do my skills again. Ah, I know what this is. It's the Emma Hardy Cleansing Balm. So excited. And this is literally the cutest thing ever. I thought it was going to be the bigger one. I don't know why I thought that, because there's no way that the bigger one would fit in this, like the one I've got just now. But that's literally the most gorgeous thing ever, and it's perfect for taking to Craig's because I use this when I take my makeup off. Okay, and number 12, which is up here, the final one for today. What's this? I'm intrigued. Oh, it's a brush. Wow, that's so cool. I'm going to open it up and have a little look. It's such a cute little brush. I love it. It'll be perfect for blusher and just taking on the go as well when I go to Craig's, because it's handy to have a little small brush. It's Monday today and I wanted to come on and just end this vlog because the last day that I vlogged, I'm just editing it just now, was the 9th of December. So that was really bad. That was about 3 days ago. But I do have a lot of footage actually. I managed to get 22 minutes of footage this week, so that's perfect because I really didn't think I had anything. I thought I might have had about 10 minutes and I was going to have to do some sort of filming today to make up for it because obviously I want a good vlog for you guys. But no, perfect, I have enough. So I'm just on here to say goodbye and I want to show you our tree. There's still a few baubles to go up here, but it's absolutely gorgeous. It's not going to focus, is it? See if we can zoom in a little, it might focus in. I don't think it's gonna struggle real. Oh, there we go, we got focus. But yeah, it's absolutely stunning. And we seem to have a little random reindeer down there and some presents. But yeah, that's pretty much what's happening today. I'm gonna edit the vlog and I'm gonna do uni work, and yeah, I'm gonna go for now and I'll see you next week. Bye.